Welcome to the Man Hour on FecTV.com. This is 1 hour of pure testosterone packed into just 15 minutes. I'm Denis Linehan, and joining me tonight is the killer bee of Bohr Bui. He's got the biggest tool in Rat Cool, and he puts the jerk in Cantork. It's Kevin Linehan. Welcome to the show, Kev.
Thank you, Denis.
You all excited to be on this show tonight?
I am very excited. I've been watching for many weeks now.
Well, I'm going to tell them what's coming up on the show now.
Cool.
Coming up in tonight's show, you're going to find out who's the sneakiest idiot of the week. Is it Lance Armstrong or is it Danny Healy Ray? We're going to be talking about Royal Rumble, which is coming up on Sunday, and we're going to be revealing why men prefer pink vaginas to red ones. So, Kev, you excited to be here? You are?
I am very excited.
And we're definitely in absolutely no way related to each other.
Nope.
No, and I didn't just, you know, cut corners and get my cousin to come on the show.
No.
Definitely didn't happen.
There's contract negotiations for the last couple of weeks.
Contract negotiations, great.
That word.
The hardest word in the world to say. We have a debate to settle this week.
Do we?
Yeah, who's going to be this week's sneakiest, biggest idiot? Is it going to be Lance Armstrong or is it going to be Danny Healy Ray? So we're going to start off with Lance.
Grand.
Right, so if you saw the interview with Oprah Winfrey, he admitted to doping in his 7 Tour de France titles.
Yeah.
He got him stripped off of him, I think, maybe about 2 months ago.
Yeah, about that.
I'm not sure, Lance. Don't sue me. It was watched by 28 million people. It was translated into 190 languages. And I meant to say 190 nations watched it, and it was translated into 30 languages. So I don't even know if there is 190 languages. Did you see the interview?
I didn't actually. I was at work, so I missed it.
Oh, great. Could you just pretend you saw the interview?
I saw this interview.
Wasn't it exciting?
Yeah. I saw it on YouTube. I didn't see it live.
In his interview, like I said, he admitted within the first 5 minutes that he, you know, was taking, or I was going to say taking dope, but he wasn't doing that. He was into the old bike doping in his,
just
his cycling
face
career.
The entire time.
Yeah. So, like I said, he lost his contract with Nike.
Yep.
He was stripped of his 2000 Olympic bronze medal and stripped of all his Tour de France titles.
Yeah.
So, the one thing I have to say from now is he did raise $500 million for cancer. And I think they worked it out. He served maybe 2.5 million people with those funds.
Yeah.
And he's still very, very, very rich.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm not too sure. I'm sure he cares a bit, but he is still a very, very rich man. So, I mean, what do you think of him? Do you think, like, where would he be on the sneaky idiot scale? Would he be like Bertie Ahern sneaky idiot? Or would he be Homer Simpson kind of sneaky idiot?
Well, he's a bit thick as well.
I suppose he is a bit thick, yeah, but I mean, he did get away with, you know.
Yeah, he did get away with it for 15 years, didn't he?
Yeah, I mean, I don't believe him. Like, I mean, you know, I think he's caught lying about lying at this stage. No, I think he is, because, I mean,
he doesn't believe himself at this stage.
No, I mean, anytime I've taken drugs and gone up on a bike, you know, like, I've been going into cars, into walls. I mean, and we surely would have known if he was on drugs. You know what I mean? Because he probably would have been, you know, going down the hills in France, like, screaming and shaking his lad in the air and stuff, like, you know.
Woo!
You don't win Tour de France after dropping a load of acid, like, so, I don't know. I think there's something fishy going on there. But,
Well, you know, he was a lot lighter as well. He's aerodynamic, you know.
I suppose he did that if he just kind of leaned over the handlebars while he was doing all of his drugs.
One testicle also helps.
He does have one testicle, and I think that was the worst joke we've ever had on on the show, and I want to apologise immediately for it. Danny Healy Ray, you live closer to the Kerry border than I do.
I do, yeah.
And this guy, Kerry County Councillor, proposed a motion that people in rural areas could, you know, drink drive, only have a point or two, he said.
Treat you, I think.
Two or three, yeah.
Yeah, two or three.
And, sorry. And,
sounds like technical here.
He said, you know, so people can get out of the house, and it'll give people in rural areas a chance to kind of get out of maybe their, you know, sinking depression or suicidal thoughts. And I mean, you know, what better way to deal with your depression than suggesting that you go drinking, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, I think...
No one's ever had problems with that before, like...
No, I mean, I was trying to think of maybe a permit that I could get, that I could, you know, if Kerry County Councillor could pass it or even turn up when I proposed it. If I could go into a bar, you know, and maybe hand this permit to a girl, you know, like probably the best looking girl in the bar, and then she'd just have to be my girlfriend and probably have sex with me, because otherwise I'd be at home and I'd just be lonely, like, and I wouldn't be having sex.
Yeah.
So I think it's a perfect solution to my predicament anyway, like, you know.
Have you been to rural Kerry pubs?
I've been to rural Kerry pubs. I haven't been to Healy Ray's pub, but I have been to Castle Island. So I'm pretty sure Jackie Healy Ray has something to do with that.
He knew a lot about.
Actually, Jackie Healy Ray, his dad, well, he is the dad.
Handsome devil.
Here's a good story going with him when they were trying to propose gondolas in the lakes of Killarney. And this motion was put forward to kind of create tourism in Killarney. You know, it's a pretty good idea. But Jackie Healy-Ray stood up and he said, and who's going to feed the gondolas? Because the poor man with the great haircut thought that they were animals. And he was just looking out for the welfare, I suppose, and the extra work that would be going around. He wasn't going to do it.
That's how the show got the name on this.
Yeah. Don't feed the gondolas. So do you think he's just doing it for votes? You know, do you think it's, is he putting on this countryman versus the big city with your fancy spaceships and motor vehicles? You know, that kind of thing. Would you agree with that point?
Well, he's definitely canvassing with this.
Yeah,
I suppose being a publican as well.
Yeah, it does help proposing people can drink and drive when you own a pub. And I suppose they could all come to his pub as well.
Yeah,
have a big drink driving night.
a rally afterwards.
Yeah, a rally. They have a drink and drive rally, yeah. Everyone could bring their families to it. Put their kids into the back seat and just go tearing around the Lake Killarney.
No seatbelts.
Yeah, no seatbelts. Who needs seatbelts when you're drunk? So we need to settle this debate. Who's the sneakiest idiot of the week? I mean, you got Lance Armstrong. He's rich. You know, he's a cheater and his career is destroyed, but he still probably lives in about several mansions. Then you've got Healy Ray, who is probably going to get re-elected because of what he just said.
Yeah.
But he has shamed the entire nation because it has gone to pretty every news outlet in the world that Ireland are now in favour of drink driving. So who's going to decide be there, the sneaky idiot of the week?
It still has to be Lance, I think, you know, to deny it for 15
years.
We're
going to go for Lance?
No, well, he did a lot of good with cancer research, but other than that.
All right, so Lance Armstrong is officially our sneakiest idiot of the week. Now, look, let's move on from these fake men. Let's move on to real men, you know, like in a real sport.
Yeah.
So could you tell the audience what's coming up on Sunday?
The Royal Rumble.
WWE, World Wrestling Entertainment, that's what's coming up. And for all the losers out there who don't know what wrestling is, could you tell them what the Royal Rumble involves?
It involves 30 half-naked men trying to throw each other over a ring for an hour.
Exactly. And why wouldn't you tune into that? So there's 30 superstars and they run in random intervals and they just throw each other over the ropes.
Yeah.
And so as a pretty big wrestling expert, who's your favourite to win the Royal Rumble this Sunday?
I don't know, really.
Do you want to go for John Cena so he can face The Rock in the championship match then in WrestleMania?
I've done my research. I think he's supposed to win it anyway. Well,
I don't know, Kevin.
He won it a couple of years
ago. You're the person with wrestling expert under your name.
You're the one that gave me that title.
I sure am. Dolph Ziggler's got a Money in the Bank match, I'm pretty sure, doesn't he?
No, he won the Money in the Bank, but he can cash in.
Oh, he can cash in his money too.
Yeah, he's either number one or number two entrant.
I'm not sure. So he can cash in his Money in the Bank and then he can hop into the ring with all the naked men.
Yeah. Well, he's starting it.
Oh, he's starting it?
Yeah, he's our number one.
So when does he get to cash in this money?
It's not actual money.
I know it's not money. Look, moving on. Tips for tips for any surprise returns. Royal Rumble is famous for old wrestlers coming back.
You never know. There could be.
You said a name earlier on to me about a tip for a surprise return.
Mick Foley. There could be. Yeah. You know, Chris Benoit.
Chris Benoit probably won't be coming back. Over that lawsuit. Were you into wrestling growing up? Have you ever competed in any, you know, backyard illegal wrestling matches?
Not backyard, apartment matches.
Apartments, yeah, that sounds recent enough, is it?
Friday night.
Friday night, nice old wrestle with your friends back from the pub. I was a professional wrestler when I was younger, from ages about 7 to 11. Won pretty much every match I went into.
Oh yeah?
I actually got buried alive by my own brother, went through hell, came back and killed him. And this happened obviously in my own imaginary world. But thinking back in it, you know, the costume I had kind of forced me into the decision about my nickname, which I kind of regret.
Yeah, what was it?
It was Captain Underpants.
Oh yes,
it was kind of you remember it?
Yes, I remember your alter ego.
Oh right, that's great. Well, I mean, no one fucked around with Captain Underpants.
No.
It was like a Bass and Booger type deal, you know. Just the underpants is all I needed. I was that strong when I was about 8 years old.
I think most people, you know, when personally superheroes have like the underwear outside the pants.
Yeah, I just had the underpants inside the superhero costume and no superhero costume, you know. it was pretty cool. I used to put it for like special events then, you know, maybe WrestleMania was coming up in my living room or something. Mm. Put like an underpants on my head then as well. You know, it wouldn't matter if it was clean or anything. I'd just kind of pull it down and just, you know, have a balaclava kind of thing going on there.
The more streaks, the better.
Yeah, my favourite underpants actually to wear when I was a wrestler was Aladdin, you know, like genie underpants.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Little did I know when I grew up that I could rub a lamp down there and a genie would pop out. I've been practicing that all day, Kevin. I didn't even get a laugh off you.
I'm actually ashamed of you.
Did you have a favourite underpants growing up?
My own.
Yeah, your own. All right. This guy. Anyway, right, I have no link to go into the next one. So,
okay.
Pink vaginas are more attractive than red ones. All right, that's. I'm just gonna fire straight in there.
Just dive right in.
In April of last year, a study showed men are more attracted to pink genitalia than red. So, right, this is based on men's attractiveness or supposed attractiveness to red, like red lipstick, girls in red dresses. Female baboons are more. Female baboons try and get their. This is science. Female baboons try and get their arses as red as they can. So then the other male baboons will come over and shift them or whatever, you know. So scientists then said, all right, well, a woman's vulva, whatever that is, gets redder when she gets aroused. So they were thinking maybe there's a reason behind this. So at the University of Kent, they showed 40 men 15 photos of vaginas, which were anonymously submitted through some website. And then the men rated it on an attractiveness from 0 to 100.
Yeah.
No, I don't know. I'm just going to guess here that maybe 40 plus was never used. You know, like I can't imagine any vagina getting like a, you know, 100 or anything, unless it was just like a line of hair just kind of just like draped across and that was it. No folds or anything going on.
It was just there hanging.
Yeah, it was just perfection. But the participants rated red vaginas as being significantly less attractive than pink ones.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
You'd agree with that? Yeah. I mean, do you have a preferred, vagina colour? Do you ever come in and just go, you know, wow, great pink vagina you got there?
I don't go and look across the bar going, red, pink, right. Pink,
as long as it's not blue and waffly, you're fine.
Yeah.
Actually, it was funny enough. I just happened to be thinking about vaginas the other day. Right, really? Strangely enough. Just popped
you,
into
really?
My head. Yeah, I know. And I was thinking, like, there'd be no way that you wouldn't lick something that looked like a vagina if it wasn't connected to a girl. Like let's say in a different world that ice cream looked like vaginas.
Yeah.
Who in the right mind would go and buy ice cream? You know, we're only going at the thing because, you know,
that'd be a very small cone.
It's a means to an end. Like, you know, it's only because some thing in the universe put it there. Like, but I mean, I'm not going to go down to the shop and buy like a packet of vaginas, something that looks like that. No one would eat them. Like,
yeah. Don't let anyone trick you that, you know, they taste like waffles either.
They don't taste like waffles. All right, we're going to be ending this show pretty shortly, but we want to do a word association game like we always do at the end. Right. Okay. I'm going to bring some, you know, topics we've been discussing in the last few minutes.
Moments.
It's called minutes. So I'm going to say a name like dog, and then you say
cat.
Cat, exactly, right? So it's simple. So I'm just going to go headlong straight into it. Okay. Keep it a bit rapid so we'll get your mind going.
I'll try.
Bicycles.
Queen.
Underpants.
Captain.
Pink.
Red.
County Councillor.
Jackie.
Oprah.
Winfrey.
Gondola.
Don't.
Robin Williams.
Robbie Williams.
Jackknife Powerbomb.
Kevin Nash.
Red.
Terra Quad.
Quicker. Ice cream.
Vulva.
Cage Flash.
Winner.
Healy Ray.
Jackie.
Cocaine.
Jackie.
Baston Booger.
Captain Funderpants.
Kevin Linehan.
Hero,
exactly.
Exceptional lover.
Exceptional lover and a hero. That's all we got time for this week, folks. Big thanks to my sexy comrade, Kevin Linehan. Woo! Great audience, thanks. Join us next week when we will be joined by the amazing Stuart Reeder, who is the founder and creator of ShyGuyLaundry.com. Now, I don't know how this happened, but he's going to be coming in and he's going to be teaching us how to buy lingerie for your woman, if you have one. He's going to say what to buy and he's going to teach us what to avoid and all the rest of it. Now, the big catch in this, and I don't know why this is happening either, and I don't know how they allowed this to happen, but we're going to have models in and they're going to model this guy's amazing lingerie collection for us. So you're going to have to tune into that. And I don't know, am I still dreaming? Am I going to wake up in a while? We're not sure, but we will see you next week. So thank you for watching. Thanks to Kevin. Thanks to everyone. Good night and good luck.